From this for water treatment. This is in addition to huge deposits of kaolinite and bentonite flakes, which could be tapped in to prepare material that is efficient for water treatment. This material will find useful application in solving pollution crises in water around the Niger Delta becomes. The use of locally sourced kaolinite flakes and the development of carbon black for waste material around us can be used to reinforce rubber material and reduce the cost of producing our polymeric material. This material, if developed further, will push out our rating as a nation and respect us at the United Nations and give respect to the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. Recommendation. Mr. Vice Chancellor, it is time for us to look inward. It is time to develop indigenous solutions to our problem. It is important for us as a nation to develop strategic plans to drive our agenda, which I call research for development, which places priority on research that solve challenges of our immediate society via sustainable and affordable methods. Any nation that ignores research and its outcome is surely paying lip service to our developmental agenda. Nigeria is blessed with abundant human and natural resources, sufficient to help to solve our challenges. Indeed, the University of Ghana has the capacity to contribute to its development and is already contributing anyway. Furthermore, Nigeria as a nation needs to prioritize the funding of research and scale-up of laboratories. Clusters of research laboratories commissioned and funded by government with the mandate to develop solutions to certain challenges of our immediate society should be set up in some of our agri towns. Finally, Mr. Vice Chancellor, it is important to mention here that all these efforts will be in vain if we do not begin to address the issue of proper mentorship in our university. The lack of proper mentorship has resulted in younger colleagues with poor research culture and poor attitude to academic activity. Any effort made to fund poorly trained academic personnel will be counterproductive, as they will not and cannot appreciate the value of what is instructed in them. It is in this light that I appeal to everyone that we consider training of our mentees properly, teaching them the culture of research, the ethics, the values, the norms, and the price of responsible research. Remember, the apple does not fall far from the tree. A good mentee will also reflect the mentor anywhere he or she is found. Acknowledgement. I would like to thank my Creator, the Almighty God, through Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior, who has made today's lecture our model contribution possible. To Him alone be the honor, the glory, and adoration. I acknowledge with gratitude my parents, Mr. Leasu and Mrs. Mokwelola Adekowale, both of blessed memory. They taught me the practice of honesty, of hard work, and fear of God. These have stood me in good stead, both in the times of peace and tumult. I want to thank my teachers from the secondary school, my secondary school from Aida Ade German School, particularly my chemistry teacher, Mr. R.A.O. Babayode, who introduced me to chemistry in class 4. It became clear that is the way that we will go. Thank you, sir. I'm equally grateful to all my teachers in the university, Professor J.A. Fanion, D.B. Adeleke, Professor Mukwelola Omotoso, F.A. Dawodo, A.A. Adesomoto, Professor O.F. Kundayo, Professor Sunday Ajayi, E.K. Adesogo, Professor Percy Oniawa, Professor O.O. Shibanjo, Professor T.I.O. Biaka, my head of department, and Professor D.B. Okumola. I want to specially thank American Professor Joseph Ayo Koko, who in 1986 instituted a departmental project to support me financially. Without which I would have dropped out of my PhD program. He later became the co-supervisor for my PhD. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling, and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory and exceeding God. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever.
Oh, quite interesting. You know, he has moved from a business to an environmental innovation. So he talked about the application of all he has been doing over the years as it was an opportunity for us to look for suitable indigenous alternatives as raw materials and the relationship with the sustainable development goals. So if we are able to take this one on board with improved facilities, then we'll contribute to national development. And that is the essence of this talk. So moving from basic science to research and innovation.
Very exciting, very enlightening, because this one inaugural lecture that talks about the importance of industrial chemistry and was broad-based, how you make alcohol, how you get oil, how you get starches from our indigenous resources. And I think the professor, I think what I didn't know what he has done, required lines for the nation to build on its commercialization.